Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back or welcome to my channel if you are new here. Before diving any further into today's video, please be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. We are trying to reach 5K, hopefully by the end of the year. That is the next goal for this channel, so be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. I apologize for the crazy looking hair today. Long story short, I did a castor oil hair mask last night and not all of it rinsed out, so it still looks greasy. So I thought, okay, high ponytail it is today. Today I'm coming at you with another low buy update video. This is obviously for the month of August. I cannot believe that we are officially in September. That is actually blowing my mind. Also, I have a little guest joining me today. Dakota's just like chilling on the couch right behind me, so I hope that you guys don't mind. She's a quiet guest, but she likes to sit there while I'm filming. Anyways, I'm just gonna dive right into today's video. You guys know how these low buy updates go. I start with a recap of the month. I go into my purchases, my grand total, and then I kind of talk to you guys about my expectations for the next month. August was actually a really great month for a lot of different reasons, but one of the main reasons being work was absolutely booming. And by work, I mean my freelancing business. As of right now, I'm completely booked through November, which is absolutely insane. And I feel so lucky and so grateful to have that stability right now. But it ended up being a pretty lucrative month for my freelancing business. And I actually had a couple jobs that kind of popped up unexpectedly. So I did have some extra money to kind of play with. I had already contributed a really decent amount into both of my savings accounts. So what I ended up doing is, I was gonna do this in September, but I decided to do it in August, is I revamped my fall wardrobe and kind of developed a fall capsule wardrobe. So I did the shopping for that this month. This definitely wasn't my cheapest month. I definitely did quite a bit of shopping, but it was for a purpose. Obviously, like, I needed some new fall clothing, and that way I didn't really have to worry about it for the rest of the year. Also, I know that I talked to you guys last month about the fact that I was going to be investing in some kind of spin bike. I was ready to kind of like just do it and make that big purchase. And then one of the cycling studios that I actually take at here in New York City ended up renting out their bikes, and I got one. So I am renting a bike instead of buying one, which has been really, really great financially because I didn't have to drop like $2,000 on a bike right now. So what I did this month is I included the bike rental fee in my like unexpected payments, but now since it's gonna be like a monthly thing, at least for the time being, it's gonna go into my baseline necessary expenses. So I won't mention it in the months to come, but for this month I did include it. I already know that by looking at the list of everything that I purchased this month, I was a bit more frivolous, even though everything did have a purpose. However, next month, meaning September, I pretty much have an exact idea of everything that I'm going to need to purchase. Again, it's not going to be my cheapest month, I don't think, but I will explain towards the end of the video. Also, I do just want to say that everything that I purchased for my fall kind of like capsule wardrobe, I am going to be including in a fall haul that I filmed a couple of days ago. So it's gonna go up probably relatively soon after this one. So without further ado, let's just get into my August purchases. I spent $40 on Amazon to buy a quiche dish and then a meat thermometer. You guys might have seen in one of my most recent vlogs that I've been absolutely loving making quiche. So it was probably one of my best investments for the month. I spent $149 on my bike rentals. So that was a bike rental fee plus tax. So that's what it's gonna be to rent a bike every single month, which honestly, I've kind of already made my money back considering the amount of classes that I've already done. I spent $147 at Nordstrom to buy some new bras and underwear. This was an expense that I was planning on making this month. You know, sometimes you just forget about those like adult purchases that you need to like re-buy every once in a while. For me, it's like bras and underwear. I always forget to buy them, and then I'm like, you know what? I just need to like invest in some new nice ones. So I went to Nordstrom, found three fantastic bras. Again, you can hear about this in another vlog that I have up on my channel, but it was a great day. I spent $47 on another Amazon order, this time for a bike mat for the bike that I'm renting. That way the floor stays protected, and if I sweat, it doesn't really matter. And then I also bought some really nice, high quality metal hair clips. I have been loving the big 90s jaw clips, and I wanted some that were good for like thicker hair, just because in the past I've never found some that really like stay in my hair. So these have been great. I'll probably talk about those actually in a Amazon favorites. I'm thinking of filming another one within the next month or so. So if you guys would like to see that, let me know in the comments down below. A lot of the fall clothing purchases were made at Nordstrom, so you're gonna hear me mention that store a couple of times. I spent $69 at Nordstrom on a new pair of amazing boyfriend jeans. They might just be the best fitting pair of jeans that I've ever bought myself. I seriously am in love with them. I've already worn them like 4 times, so it's really been a great investment. I spent $75 at Nike. I bought some new sneakers. Again, another Amazon order. I spent $29. I purchased 2 belts, specifically high-waisted belts, just surprisingly very hard to find, and they can get really expensive really fast. So I found a brand on Amazon, and wow, the game has just totally been changed for me. I spent $69 at Abercrombie on 2 pairs of jeans, which is kind of like the best deal in the world. I cannot believe that they were having such a great sale. And then because I joined the rewards program, I got like another $10 off or something. I spent $79 on urbanoutfitters.com. I bought 2 new sweaters. Again, they're gonna be featured in my haul. You guys, these are seriously so ridiculously cute. I can't wait to share them with you guys. I spent $5 on Amazon. I purchased a keratin nail treatment. I usually use a nail strengthener from OPI, but it runs about $17. So it's definitely not the cheapest. So I was looking for a cheaper alternative because I was running out of the OPI one, and then I found the keratin one on Amazon for like $5. It had amazing reviews. I only bought it about a week ago, so I really can't tell you if it's working. I have it on my nails today. It leaves a very glossy finish, so it kind of looks the same as the OPI nail treatment. I'm hoping it works just as well, so we shall see. I spent $89 at Sephora on a face mask and some face oil. I'm just trying my best to prevent that maskne because you guys know I am a little bit more on the acne prone side. So far, so good. I haven't had any major breakouts from wearing a mask, but I'm just looking to try and prevent it as much as I can. And then last but certainly not least, at Nordstrom during their anniversary sale, I picked up a new pair of boots, a leather jacket, and then a basic black dress. Again, all of those are gonna be featured in my fall haul. I cannot wait for you guys to see these pieces. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and add up the grand total and I will be right back with you guys. Okay, so my grand total for August was $986. Is that high? Yes. It is not my highest month. I still believe last month was a little higher, or maybe it was June. However, I will say I was still able to contribute a very substantial amount to both of my savings accounts as well as my investments. And I don't really plan on spending that much again, but I do think that the pieces that I invested in will last me for months and years to come, and that way I won't have to do that shopping later on this year. I also think that this was the perfect month to shop because every single store was having some sort of sale, whether that be Nike or Nordstrom's anniversary sale. So I think if I would have put the shopping off until later, I would have actually spent more. However, I definitely am ready to have a lower month because I know that, you know, the first like 5 or 6 months of the slow buy, my numbers were relatively low, and the last few months have been a little higher, but for necessary reasons. However, during the month of September, like I said, I pretty much have everything written down that I'm going to have to purchase. June and July were birthday filled months, and September is actually a month full of celebrations as well. If you guys don't know, my boyfriend Kevin and I are actually gonna be celebrating our 3-year anniversary together, and then 3 days after our anniversary is his birthday. So obviously I'm gonna be spending some money on anniversary gifts for him and a birthday gift for him. There are also a couple things that I know I'm gonna need to pick up from Amazon, but I know that they can wait until probably the middle or end of September, but I know I'll probably have to place some sort of Amazon order during the month of September. I'm also probably gonna purchase or try out a new hair serum. The one that I currently use, just to make sure that like I never deal with any sort of like hair thinning or female hair loss. I love it, but it's about to run out and it's actually like not coming back in stock. So there's a new one that I know I want to try, and that's something that I use almost every single day, every single time I take a shower. So I know that I'll probably be purchasing that. And then really the last thing that I know I'm going to be spending money on in September is a new hair color. Long story short, you guys know I typically do cut and color my own hair. I've been doing that for quite a while now. But I've been thinking of doing kind of like a really fun hair transformation for the fall and winter while, you know, like audition season isn't happening. It's like the perfect time to just try something different with my look. If I don't like it, I can always go back to the red. If I do like it though, great, and I'll just get new headshots with that hair color. But I don't know, I just want to try something different, and I think it's gonna be a pretty hefty process. So I decided that I wanted to kind of treat myself and go to a really nice salon for that. I'm trying out a new salon for the first time, but I've heard great reviews about it, so I'm really excited. I'm not gonna go for a cut though, just to save on money. I'm gonna cut my own hair a few days before the appointment. I actually gave my hair a trim today, but I'm just gonna be paying for the color. It's still gonna be relatively expensive because every single, you know, colorist in New York is definitely on the more expensive side. But other than that, I think that that's pretty much all I'm gonna be spending my money on in September. I can't see it being a super high month, probably definitely over like the 400 or 500 mark, just because of the gifts that I want to buy Kevin and also my hair appointment, but I definitely think that it's gonna be a lower total than the month of August. So there you guys have it. That is my low buy update for the month of August. I really hope that you all did enjoy this video. If you did, be sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. We are trying to hit 5K, hopefully by the end of the year. I really, really do think that we can do it. You guys have been absolutely amazing recently with your engagement. So many of you have been liking my videos and commenting, and it just warms my heart. So if you enjoyed this video, leave a comment. I promise I will answer each and every one of them. Follow me on all of my other social media networks. Links are always in the down bar below. Subscribe to my podcast. That's brand new. That'll be announced by the time you guys are watching this video, which is so exciting. I hope you all are having an awesome day, night, afternoon, whenever you all are watching this video, and I will talk to you all in my next one. Okay, bye everybody.